Does your to-do list look like this? Overflowing, overwhelming, and never-ending? Let's face it, juggling tasks, projects, and assignments can feel impossible. But what if I tell you there is a way to transform your chaotic to-do list into a powerful tool for success? I will share some tips and tricks to organize your to-do list, boost productivity, and reclaim time. First of all, I recommend using task management apps with features like deadlines, reminders, and collaboration. It would also be great if the app synced with your Google calendar or the calendar that you use to provide a holistic view of your schedule. In my case, I will be using Kanbanchi. This tool has all the necessary features to organize a to-do list. My first tip will be to prioritize tasks, because when I look at my to-do list, I have absolutely no clue what should I start with. So let's open any of these tasks and set priority. In this particular tool, it can be from low to critical. And obviously, I will focus on the critical items first and then move to less critical ones. So let's say that this one will be high priority task. Also, in this tool, Kanbanchi, I can sort list by priority, so which is also great. Another way to enhance your to-do list, and this is a really easy one, is to allocate specific time slots for each of your tasks. And this will help you set boundaries and maintain focus. Let's say I would like to set a start and due date for this task, like this. And I would like to see these dates in my calendar. Okay, here it is. So this is a great advantage of digital online tools for to-do lists, because first of all, you will receive notifications about your dates, and also you can integrate with your Google Calendar, so you have all your stuff in one scheduling service. My next tip will be to try to group tasks by categories, such as design, development, content, etc. So you just need to think about different categories that you may split your workflow into. This will help you to focus on related cards together and understand to what aspect of your work a specific task belongs. So I've created several color labels for my board, so let's apply them to some of the cards that I have. For example, this one will be with the content label, as well as this one. So you see, like, everything connected with content will have its own color label. And you can see how these color labels, they bring color to the space, and they also make navigation easier. In general, this kind of visual cues, for example, color labels or even color coding, they help quickly identify task's nature and make navigation very easy. Let's color code some of the cards, and we can basically do it just for fun, just to bring some color. You may think about different, again, aspects of your work and color code, thinking about some kind of system of your workflow, or you can do it just for fun. My next tip will be to break down tasks. To avoid feeling overwhelmed, it is important to clearly define each step needed to complete a task. So let's open our card. In this tool, I have checklists, so I will use this feature. So let's say we need to prepare mockups. Our next step will be to share them with the team. So let's rename it. I think it will be just team review. Our next item will be approval. Also, I can identify the weight of each of the items just to make sure that the team understands what should be done in the first place. And the progress of this card will be calculated accordingly. So you see this progress is 83 now. I highly recommend breaking large tasks into smaller, manageable pieces. This makes complex tasks more approachable and provides a sense of progress. Marking items as done is so satisfying, and we actually need this to feel productive. You can see that I have everything in this one to-do list on this board devoted to my project, but I want to actually see to which stage of the project each task belongs. Therefore, I need to fix the structure, so my next step is to structurize. And I will add some new lists and then rename them. I think I need the planning, also execution, maybe testing. Let's do a list for launch, and we need a list for project closure. Now I can move tasks to corresponding stages, just like this, with simple drag and drop. So you see, like, now it's not just a to-do list, it is the whole workflow. Please don't try to handle the whole to-do list on your own. If there is a task that can be handled by others, delegate it and free up your time for more critical tasks. So I think I will assign this task to my teammate. Maybe this one too. And I will definitely need to invite more people to this board. Implementing these strategies can help create a more organized, effective, and manageable to-do list, improving productivity and reducing stress. Kanbanchi can assist you all the way through. Check out the description box for a 40% discount on your first purchase.